Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, man, today was the day that John Constantine's TV show, Constantine, arrived on NBC. And obviously, today is October 24th, 2014. Right now, I'm going to make this really, really quick podcast, probably like 5 minutes, maybe four. But we're going to talk about the DC comic TV shows that we have that are on television right now, which ones are great, which ones need improvement. And which one have, I guess, the most potential? And I'm also going to throw in a couple of Marvel stuff also. First off, let's talk about John Constantine because this is his night. Season one, pilot episode. I think they fell kind of flat. Now, comparing it to the pilot episode of Arrow, the pilot episode of The Flash, pilot episode of Gotham, and the pilot episode of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Constantine beats out Arrow, Shield, and that's it. The Flash is going to come right after that. Right after Constantine will be the Flash. The number one right now for the pilot episode is going to be Gotham. It's going to be Gotham. And I think they just didn't play around. I think that they really took it serious. Not saying that NBC played around, they didn't take their source material serious. No, I think that they created this first pilot episode for comic book fans, and they left behind the rest of the audience. I really, really do believe that, man, because had a small watch party and people were falling asleep. People weren't interested, people left. So that says a lot. I don't know how the reviews are going to go. I don't know how people are going to be taking it. I know I enjoyed it. I gave it 8.5 out of 10 stars. Gotham, I gave 10 out of 10 stars. The Flash pilot, I gave 10 out of 10 stars. Arrow pilot, I also gave it, I think, an 8 out of 10 stars way back then. And then the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. episode, I think I gave that a 7 or an 8. That kind of just shows you something. Now, the show that has the most potential right now for me. And I mean, Gotham, I think, is going to be a perfect for me. Right now, I have every single episode of Gotham 10 out of 10 stars. I think that Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. has the most potential for this growth, man. And Constantine, I don't know, man. I don't know. Right now, I'm going to go ahead and say that Constantine will be canceled. That's my prediction. And it might change once episode two and three comes. But as of right now, I think Constantine will be canceled, man. I don't think people are going to watch it. I don't know, but we'll have to see. And when I say Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. has the most potential right now, season two was completely revamped. They did a really, really great job. I don't know what the hell Arrow season three is doing right now. They were, how do you want to say it? They changed up everything, but they didn't change anything. What I mean by that? They got rid of the island. They put you on land inside of Japan or China or one of those Asian countries, and then they kept the shaky camera. They kept the, unnecessary flips and unnecessary parkour. They kept all the stupid things about the show, the love, the romance. And then they threw in, Brandon Routh, which is Superman, and then they're not doing anything with him. And then after that, they're talking about getting rid of the guy, man. But oh, man. The Flash. Let's talk about the Flash real quick, man. The Flash for me, I think, is it's starting to get really, don't know, high schooly. It just feels like it's filled with teen drama, and these are grown-ups, man. So that's I mean, it turned into a love triangle where it's like, dude, this I can't do that. I can't do it anymore, man. I really can't. And I'm so thankful that Fox, they're trying to go that route, you know what I'm saying? But they're utilizing the love triangle for a purpose and a reason, you know what I'm saying? Like a meaning behind it. And they immediately got rid of Barbara off of Gotham, man, because that was stupid. It was like, yo, nobody cares what Jim Gordon is dating or if he's dating or if he's not. I just want to see Batman. I want to see Catwoman. I want to see Jim Gordon arrest people. So, yeah. Let me see. We got some Marvel stuff coming up for Netflix next year. Pretty much, man, this is all I'm waiting for, man. I've been waiting for Constantine for a while. I'm still happy that I was able to sit down and watch it. I just think that they should have brung a little bit better. I don't even think anybody watched it after the editing team got done with it. That shouldn't have been the pilot episode. That's all I'll say about that, man. Let me see. We talked about Gotham, talked about Arrow, talked about Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., talked about The Flash. I think that's it, man. I'm going to end it here, man. Right now, my ratings go like this. Number one is Gotham. Number two would be The Flash. Number three is going to be Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Number four would be Constantine, and number five would be Arrow. And that's how it goes as of right now. I'm hoping that people, you know, get out there and they support these DC Comics stuff. If you're a geek, man, if you're a nerd, man, put it on your DVR. If you can't watch it live, you know, play it back. Make sure you're putting in some time, man. Buy the stuff on Amazon. Buy the stuff on iTunes. Buy the episodes, man. Buy it. Whether it's digital download, whatever, man. If you want it to go to Blu-ray faster, stop buying the digital. That's all I got to say about that. You know, these, you know, on digital HD first and then Blu-ray 2 weeks later, you know, stop buying digital if you want it to come on Blu-ray faster, man. That's all I got to say. Anyway, guys, I'm out of here, man. Let me know what you think about, you know, the DC comics, the Marvel comics, and just comic books, comic book shows in general. And what's your rating, man? What do you rate the shows, man? I'm going to have a giveaway coming out pretty soon, so make sure you're commenting. This one is going to be a surprise, man. So if you're commenting, you're already on it right here. Thanks again for watching. And, yeah, that's it. I think I went over the mark, man. It's almost 7 minutes.